actually looks like a little flower vase.
Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back. In this video today, we are gonna be turning sand into glass. I jumped down to the comments and I found this one from JC112, who has been begging us to please make glass from sand. Today, we're trying to make it happen for you. Now to make this happen today, I had to bring my friend Cody from Cody's Lab. You know him.
Hi everyone.
And we've also got Andy from a channel called How to Make Everything. You might know him as the guy who took 6 months to make a chicken sandwich. He did everything from scratch, including growing the grain and spawning the chicken.
On my channel, Explore, what if you couldn't go to a store and buy stuff? You need to make it from natural sources.
Sweet, so I'm looking at this as kind of like, I don't know what you call that, like Power Rangers. We got like all the forces joining together here to see if we can accomplish one great task, because it's not very easy to turn sand into glass, is it?
Especially not clear glass.
So this will actually be my fourth attempt at it. I've tried various things, used a different flux of potash made from hardwood ashes. This is my first attempt with soda ash, and hopefully we'll have some better results.
So for this video, we're gonna put everything to the test. We're gonna use raw materials that Andy sourced himself. We're gonna use the materials that Cody refined, and we're gonna put them all together and see if today we can actually make clear glass with our backyard trash can foundry. Let's dive right in.
All right, so I have ingredients from four different states, actually. I have sand I collected in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Then in Wyoming, I collected sodium carbonate and sodium sulfate from a lake there. Arizona, I collected gypsum from an old mine. Then Utah, Cody helped me find some calcite.
So my role here is basically the chemistry guy. I helped Andy purify his sodium carbonate. I also helped him purify the sand a little bit, and also sourced the nitric acid, which we will convert into calcium nitrate by reacting with some more calcite. And if we don't have enough, we might cheat a little bit.
So the time has come, guys. We're gonna take all of these ingredients and we're gonna mix them all together. And here's how we're gonna do it. We're gonna take this sand that's already had most of the iron washed out. We're gonna mix it up with some of this sodium carbonate and add a little bit of calcium nitrate and a bit of gypsum. We're gonna crush it all into a very fine powder, mix the mixture together, throw it down in a crucible, and let the whole thing nuke for about 6 to 12 hours in our trash can foundry. This is the kind of glass that nature makes. This is obsidian, it comes out of a volcano, and you can see it's not very transparent at all. Clear glass is a very cool thing, and we're gonna replicate it here today.
So I guess I'm mixing together the materials. Here's the sand. I think we're just gonna mix these together. Just kind of guess at the ratios. I'm gonna try to shoot for about 30% by weight sodium carbonate, which I'll crush into a fine powder here.
Hulk smash, Hulk smash. Who needs a mortar and a pestle? He's actually crushing it pretty well. I mean, my knuckles are starting to hurt and bleed a little bit, but I think it's worth it. This is the Industrial Revolution, baby. Two fists, twice as fast energy.
All right, so we're gonna mix together the ingredients now. Since the sand is still a little wet, its weight's gonna be off, so there's really no sense weighing it. I'm just gonna kinda mix together an equal volume of sand and sodium carbonate here.
It's like a one-to-one ratio?
Well,
although we don't have
this is a lot less dense than this, and we only need about 20 to 30% sodium carbonate, so. I have to use all of this. The more of this we use, the lower the melting point will be and the easier it will be to melt.
See, this is the kind of cooking I enjoy when we're cooking with recipes from Cody's Lab.
All right, so a little bit of gypsum. This will release some gases towards the end, which will actually counterintuitively help the other gases come out.
So just to clarify, this is that crushed up crystal that we had from earlier.
Exactly.
So solid form, powdered form. It's amazing difference.
Yeah. I believe this is the final ingredient, just a little bit of calcium nitrate. This is a oxidizer that'll help burn out impurities, and hopefully it'll turn the sand from kind of a beige color into pure white, and then it'll melt to a clear. Let's just sprinkle in a bit of that. Doesn't really matter if I add too much because it'll burn off. All right, I'll just mix it up. Oh, actually there's one more ingredient we're missing. That's the lime. So here's the lime. This is actually hydrated lime or calcium hydroxide. This is what happens when you add the calcium oxide to water. And this will be our lime part of the soda lime glass. Now we're probably not gonna add very much because it will raise the melting point, but it will increase the chemical resistance of the glass, make it insoluble in water. So yeah, we just a few percent in there. Yeah, it won't be the best drinking cup glass, but it'll probably work for, it'll look, you know, pretty good for a window or whatever. All right, there it is. Still a little wet. I think that'll work.
We got our powder crushed up, ready to go. Our crucible is still pretty hot from when we fired it earlier. It's ready to go. So let's mix it all together, fire up the foundry, and get ready to rock. Yeah! That sand looks a lot more white now that you mixed everything into it.
Yeah.
So now, Andy, since this is your fourth attempt, why don't you tell us what you think is going to happen here today?
I'm still pretty skeptical. It has kind of turned into our white whale of actually making clear glass. I think we're going to get pretty close. I'm pretty confident in Cody's ability to actually refine stuff, but I'm expecting that it's not going to be perfect. It's probably a little few bubbles, but I think we could get pretty close.
That's, of course, assuming that the metal foundry is going to get hot enough to actually do its job. So we are going to put it to the test. We're going to throw everything in, fire this thing up, put the cap on, and basically just let it marinate on high heat for about 6 to 12 hours.
All right, let's put that in there. Just as a little bit of insurance, I'm going to have a second batch of glass going, a slightly different composition. Got another furnace over here, and if this doesn't work out, well, we'll have something else that I think is a little bit more likely to turn out as nice, clear glass.
Oh, so it's the competition of the equipment.
So for the second batch, I've got some sand, which is probably a little bit more pure. And I'm going to mix this with, instead of using soda lime, I'm going to use soda lead. So this is a mixture here of lead oxide, so PbO, and sodium carbonate. This is actually very heavy because this is over half lead right here. So I'm just going to mix this in with the sand. And This theoretically should make crystal glass. This should melt at a lower temperature, so I think we might have a little bit better luck with it. Here we go. Let's go put this in the other furnace. Got the crucible here, heating inside the furnace. Just gonna pull this out and add our material, which hopefully will flux down and make something that resembles clear glass. We just have this kind of going alongside. Bring it up to 2,000 degrees. Melt. All right.
All right, now we wait. Hopefully we get something good. All right, guys, it is the moment of truth. Our foundry's been running for 6.5 hours. So this has been completely molten. We've stopped it a couple times, released the lid, and tapped the crucible a few times to let the bubbles rise to the top, theoretically. We're not really sure how clear the glass is yet, but we've got some tools we're gonna use to pull it out and see if we can blow it, mold it, and perhaps make a small improvised window. Let's see what we got. Whoa, my goodness, that is hot. Hot stuff. Oh, that's cool. Just like that. It's drippy, drippy wet. Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's kind
of... Is that metal?
Yeah, it is.
Oh, that's cool. Is it gonna stick to the steel? No? All right, so we made the transfer. We got the glass in a little bin. Let's talk about what just happened there. We got two pieces of glass sitting in our container right now. One is from the trash can foundry. We had a little bit of trouble with it because when I was putting it into the heat, it touched the side of the crucible, it got sticky, and then working it around, it actually got little bits of kale wool that stuck to it, so it wasn't perfectly clear. And then we tried mashing it down, it was very, very hard, and it started cracking, all kinds of problems, but we think we saved it, ran it through a few more batches and put it into a container where it can cool down without cracking.
Also got the other bit of glass with the leaded glass. I ended up pouring that out onto the plate along with a bunch of lead because it had reacted with the crucible and formed metallic lead.
We just poured that out on a steel plate, mashed it down, and then transferred it over to the container as well. So only time will tell now. We're gonna give it about half an hour to cool down and then take a look at what we got. So while the glass is cooling, we're sticking it into a bucket full of vermiculite, which is gonna help that cool down at a little bit slower rate. It's gonna help the heat stay in as long as possible to prevent the glass from cracking. Now, ideally, you'd wanna actually anneal this glass so that it doesn't crack in the future. If you use this as a window pane, it would eventually crack due to the weather, the temperature, things of that nature. So it would need to be annealed. However, for this video, we just wanted to show proof of concept, and I think we did it. Check it out, guys. We have successfully turned sand into glass. We are most of the way there. We've got like a little bit of a greenish tinge to these, which means there's still a bit of iron in there. But for the most part, this stuff is looking pretty good, and it definitely is glass. Look at this piece that Cody has here. It's acting a lot like a lens. This is Cody's batch that was the leaded glass. It's got a really cool blue tinge to it. It's very interesting. There are some bubbles in there, but it is clear. It's relatively clear. So maybe if we cooked that longer, we could have got it even more transparent. Little chunks of lead stuck in there. It gives you a whole new appreciation for like windows and glass bottles and things that are everywhere.
Definitely.
So we also attempted to blow some of the lead glass, you know, put it on the end of the rod, and we blew an air bubble inside of it. It actually looks like a little flower vase.
You like grow your little apple seeds.
It actually turned out fairly decent.
That's cool. I like the blue tinge too. And we also made a little marble, a little purple marble. I'm not sure where that coloring came from.
You know, my guess is probably because it had lead on the pan that we rolled it across.
Well, that's pretty cool. How cool is that? We made our own marbles. So marbles, little tiny flower pots, broken glass, all part of an epic adventure. So let's take a second and just briefly recap how we got to this point today. We start off with sand that Andy collected from the Mississippi River. He brought out here and used Cody to help purify some of the chemicals, and we put it in the trash can foundry and let it marinate for almost 7 hours. We noticed that the sand actually melted into glass within about half an hour. We stirred it up a little bit and we watched it and gave it about 6 more hours after that to melt down and hopefully let some of those bubbles release. Now just for fun, we reached down into the crucible with a steel rod, we got a little bit of that glass out and tried rolling it into a ball and then flattening it out. The idea was maybe we could make some kind of an improvised piece of window. I'm not really sure that that's what we got, but we definitely got glass. And if you look at it, it's relatively transparent, a little bit of a greenish tinge, but all in all, it's really not too bad considering we just made this in our backyard.
It's definitely glass and it's definitely transparent. You can see through it, but it still has some bubbles, so it's not quite like optically clear. Not perfect for lenses, but really close. And I think a little bit more tweaking and baking along in the kiln and we'll probably have it.
Yeah. Might even be able to crush this up and remelt it. Now, this is glass. It'll be much easier to work with now. And I think if we had maybe a bit more skills with glass working, we might have been able to do it.
Yeah.
So it's not clear glass, but it is glass. We can crush this up, we can remelt it, we can use it again. And this was really just a first attempt at any kind of glass working at all. I think if our skills improve or we happen to run into the right people with the right kind of talents, perhaps we can actually end up making crystal clear glass. That is the goal. That is the end achievement. We're just starting out on that journey. It's been a ton of fun. Thanks so much to Andy and Cody for joining us for this experiment today. As I mentioned, I've put their links down in the description. You can go check out their channels. They do some incredible things on their channel, like Andy spending 6 months to make a chicken sandwich just so you can appreciate what goes into it. And Cody doing all kinds of mind-blowing chemical experiments, a lot of things that you shouldn't do at home. That's why I like them. That's why I like these guys. And of course, a big shout out to our friend JC112 who put this request down in the comments and got over 1,100 likes. Good job, man. You can go check your YouTube inbox for sending you 25 bucks. Thanks for joining us for this experiment today. We'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then.
You're a wizard, Harry.
Hey guys, there is an event called CVX Live that I'm gonna be at August 3rd through 5th. Stage presentations, meet and greets, there's even a special super fan experience where we can hang out one-on-one. So click the link in the description and I'll be looking for you at CVX Live.